Hey, Traders Raghi here, and in this free update, let's talk about sort of the juxtaposition of the 1 minute time frame setups that we've been doing in the room and the longer term daily time frame setups we've also been focused on. So first of all, I've had, generally speaking, a bullish bias, and that was until the Fed cut 50 basis points just the other day. So some of that goes into the history of what's happened in the past after the Fed has done that kind of cut, either two 25 basis points cuts in a row, you know, very quickly, or as we saw this week, a surprise 50 basis point all at once, half percent. That's kind of a panic move, isn't it? And the market typically does not take that well. And what happens is this expectation of what is it that we don't know? What is it that the central bank knows? And things are probably pretty bad. And it does, I think, change the winds, if you will. All right. With all that being said, here's a juxtaposition. This morning, we took long positions in the NASDAQ based on the fact that during the first 1 hour of trading after the bell rings, we're better off typically fading the highs and lows. Now, I don't mean fading using my HPMRs. You know, this is a calculation I created using AutoChartist levels to project historically valid support and resistance. That is not going to work right now because historically valid means that when we get a sudden increase in volatility like we have right now, the HPMRs don't work that well. I would know. I created them, right? So what we want to know is the limitations, even of tools we love. So here I am telling you, there's a limitation of this tool that I created that I love. And we have to know the Achilles heels of the tools that we use. And that's the Achilles heel here. So we fade the extremes. And I've been using another tool that I created called the V-score to do it, looking at the standard deviation measurement of volume-weighted average price. So that's been a really great tool to use, volume-weighted average price and the V-score, in order to take advantage of the choppy action and fades in the morning. And then that pretty much carried us through the day. It was a terrific follow-through. But here's where a lot of traders are wondering, well, are things back to normal? And I don't believe that they are. At the top of the range, and this is something we'll talk a lot more about in the premium video, but there's a top of the range and there's a bottom of the range. And at the top of the range, I'm focused on the short side of the market. At the bottom of the range, as we close in on, say, the 200 exponential propulsion dot there, or even these Darvis lows, 8200 being a psychological level, I will likely focus on support and buys, but we're getting very close to the level, the last level that we looked for shorts from. So depending on which end of the zone you're at, top of the range, bottom of the range, is going to change the direction of the trade. So today's rally just inches us that much closer to a zone that I would like to short, and we'll talk more about that going forward. But absolutely on the daily, I'm going to be a willing and likely active short seller between about 9,000 and the point of control for the year. Intraday, however, I'm looking a little bit differently. Intraday, we're looking at fading the first 60 minutes, and then after we get an initial balance break, which way can we play the VWAPs? And that's really been, again, the juxtaposition of these two time frames. You can be short on one, long on the other, because they really are two very different slices of psychology. I hope that gives you something to think about. I hope that frees you up to make different types of trades in this market, and I'll see you in the next update.